Just trying to go in at a good angle. I don't know if the speed is going to throw off my shell a bit. Center mass. Oh my god. This gun is amazing. Oh, oh, oh god. Building, building, building. Oh, hey. I'm good. That's why I got two engines. Hello, hello, everybody. I'm HappyBacon777 and welcome back to WarThunder. So first and foremost, wow. I am honestly shocked that the first video I made coming back, even though it wasn't, like, personally, I think it wasn't, like, the best I could do, but I'm still surprised at the, well, the response that it received. It got, like, quite a bit of views just after the first couple days it got released, so, wow, thank you. But that is not the showcase of today's video. I remember when I tried to play that one plane that, it was the Italian one, the one plane that had the flying cannon. Well, you know what, I'm gonna try it again. Hopefully this is gonna be a lot better because I'm going to be using the PBJ. What's really nice about this is that it's at 3.7, but it's got a 75mm cannon, and it actually penetrates a good amount of armor. Now, of course, looking at this, obviously, I don't have a whole lot of experience with this gun, but I think I've heard that it's a little bit easier to aim with this, and if that's not good enough, I mean, eventually, you get a 2,000-pound bomb, and on top of that, you get 850 caliber machine guns, so at 3.7, you should be able to rip apart pretty much anything. And even though these gunners, obviously everybody knows that gunners are completely useless in War Thunder, you got something, so, I mean, hey, they're there. And our choice of poison to somehow take out this plane is, of course, going to be the M24 Chaffee because it's 3.7. A 3.7 on a 3.7 attacker, always, I mean, that's the way to go. Honestly, you could probably take this plane out at a higher battle rating. You could probably go through the side of a lot of Panthers. You know, make some higher tier people pretty angry. But, I mean, what is there to say about the Chaffee? It's a fast light tank. It's got a good 75mm gun. And the shell that it fires, it's a pretty... Actually, you know what? Hold on. We are going to do some quick diving right quick. Well, look at that. It's an M24 Chaffee that can fly. Beautiful. But enough of that. Let's hop into battle. Let's see what we can do. Let's see if we can actually manage to score some hits with this gun and maybe get a couple kills. And without further ado, let's go. So a quick little yap session before we get into the, you know, spoiler alert, scouting montage. I like this tank. I really do. Obviously I got some pretty dope camo, but I'm pretty sure this tank was also liked amongst its crews for its very long service time. Very reliable tank. I mean, what more could you want for a light tank? It's pretty small, got a good gun, and yeah, it rocks. And, well, I say that, and we suddenly can't crawl up this mountain. Actually, no, yes we can. All right, the time to start the scouting montage hopefully starts now. Alright folks, we've wrapped up quite a bit of kills, so I guess it's time to put the pedal to the metal, charge in, get killed to finally bring out that big hunk of love. Oh, hello. Oh, aw, man, I kind of feel bad. Yep, right there should do it. Oh god, that's a big guy. Oh, it's always nice to pull out the Chaffee. It's just, it's the perfect light tank for its battle rating, and look at me. I got, now I have the gun on a plane. It is mounted kind of to the bottom left, so if you think about it, this is almost like a really, really old school A-10, because the A-10 also has its gun mounted. I think it's the same where it's like to the bottom left, but we are going to see if we can actually get a hit. That's all I'm hoping for. If I can get a hit with this gun, I'll be happy. All right, you know what? I saw a very big target over here. We are going to try for a gunner's aim. Oh, wow, this is actually really nice. Oh! Oh, wow! This is actually so much better than that Italian plane. The gunner's sight is actually on point. Wow. Oh, I can't wait to kill some more. All right, unfortunately, there is that anti-air that's honestly really, really mad at us. We've got a friendly French plane going in, doing a good strafe on him. We're going to try to shoot third person now. We'll see how that works. Well, 50 cals. Oh my god, he blew me up. Oh, you know what I just realized? Surprise, I do not leave the battle. That's why I bring out other tanks, because, you know, just because I lose the tank that I've been playing, you know, it doesn't mean I'm going to leave the battle. But I want to note that it's not a Frenchie. That is a Swedish plane, I think. I don't know. I don't know a whole lot about this. I just see that roundel and my brain instantly goes France. But yes, fun battle. I'm going to wrap this up with the M4 Sherman. Hopefully we can still win. Needless to say, I think I racked up a little bit more kills, obviously enough to pull out this plane again. So let's see if we can get just one more kill. You know, having 8 machine guns might also work against planes. Let's see if we can angle this good. Oh, my wing. Oh god, my wing was blocking my line of sight on that. Okay, quickly, let's see if we can swap to some type of target on the ground. I can't see anybody. Oh, he is behind me. Come on, gunners, do your work. Come on. Oh, they're so inaccurate. Well, also, I'm kind of inaccurate. I'm just trying to lead. Also, I'm not trying to overheat my guns. See if we can swing around. Okay, there he is. Let's see if we can get him as he's passing by. Okay, he is on fire. We should take care of him. There was some more anti-airs shooting at us, of course. Ah, there he is. Good old 50 cals, just 8 of them, no problem. Oh, wow, yeah, he got us, though. You know what? I think that was a very successful game. You know what? People in the comments, you beautiful people, let me know what your favorite light tank is, because I know a lot of people like the Puma, but also I want to hear some other really good light tanks for other nations, because I'll be honest, medium tanks are cool, heavy tanks cool, but light tanks, there's just something so funny and so silly to just scuttle around, just scurrying all over the map like a rat, and somehow pulling off more kills than anybody else on your team, even though you can get killed by like a machine gun. I always love tanks like that, so yeah, let me know what you guys like, and I'll see if I can check it out. Well, we have finally enough to pull out the girthy plane, so I am just cruising around trying to find out a good way to die. But it looks like we accidentally killed way too much people on this side of the map, but you know what? I'll just hide behind a hill and hope somebody can come up and kill me. Oh, a Puma death. Very nice. Ah, no, never mind. There we go, just perching on top of a hill. I'm not moving until either the enemy dies or I do. You know what? I see the way this battle's going. I mean, they have no spawn points left. I normally don't do that. I normally don't, like, leave my vehicle, but hey, listen. We gotta roll her out. I will say, and I love this shell, because it's not just a high-penetrating shell. It's actually got explosive filler in it. So I cut my engines, obviously, so I don't overspeed. There is a Panzer IV. I don't know if you guys can see it. He's like right there. Just trying to go in at a good angle. I don't know if the speed is going to throw off my shell a bit. Center mass. Oh my god. This gun is amazing. Oh, oh, oh god. Building, building, building. Oh, hey, I'm good. That's why I got 2 engines. Oh, I can shoot back. Just because I'm not pointing at you doesn't mean I can't fight. I think I got a hit. I call that a success. And you know what? I don't know if it's just me or you guys also experience the same thing, but every single time I try to pull out a big, fun back plane for ground RB, the enemy team suddenly has 5 anti-air, 2 fighters, every single time without fail. Yet whenever they pull out, like, a huge plane, like a PE-2 or something like that, PE-8 or whatever. Suddenly, my team has no anti-air. They can do whatever they want. They can have a fun time. I can never have a fun time in heavy fighters. I mean, that's why it's like, if I can get one kill with a heavy fighter on a ground RB, I'm cool with it, because past that, you really can't go beyond that. I mean, you do have some lucky games here and there, but they definitely do not make up for the amount of times that you just get rolled by the enemy team. Oh, it was a BT-7. Oh man, I would do anything to have that 2,000 pound bomb right about now. Oh, jeez, because it's such a good bomb. I mean, obviously, it's 2,000 pounds, and of course there's a fighter right there. Oh, here he comes. Please, please, let me get one person. Just one. Oh, that's an anti-air. Yep. Okay, there we go, with another anti-air. I don't have a bomb, can't do nothing about it. Oh, here comes trees. I got killed by a milk truck. It's actually kind of amazing because my sanity for using this plane is degrading exponentially with every single time I pull it out. It's still, like I said, it's a fun plane, but a milk truck kills me. You know, that's enough to bring anybody to their knees. Oh, I was concentrating on him too much. Oh, come on, people. Please. Well, all of you astute individuals will probably tell there is a lot of people on Bravo. So that means, yes, sir, one kill, maybe, please. If I had the 2,000 pound bomb, it would work amazing. If I had my Sky Shark with a 4,000, these are the times where I wish I had my Sky Shark. But of course, I just got a lumbering bathtub with a tank cannon slapped onto it. But you know what? We're gonna try to put it to some use. All right, I'm locked in. Right there. You know what? Fuel tanks. Oh, tree. It's always the trees. Oh my gosh, it's because the plane is wide. Well, yep, that was one ground and one tree too many. This is a plane. This is definitely a plane. It works in certain situations, I won't lie. I was having very fun, but it quickly dwindled on down. You have to have air superiority, obviously, and I think I am hindered a lot because I don't have the big bombs. But you know what? It still works, and yeah, you get armor-piercing bombs. Have fun against ships. Honestly, this thing might work pretty well against ships, but of course, personally, I'm not touching naval. Ew, disgusting. Keep that away from me. But yeah, I mean, if you look at in terms of the tech tree, the only other plane that I think would touch this in terms of, you know, ground attack, obviously the P-47, maybe the early P-51, like this P-51, it's one, I mean, 0.7 bow rating higher, 0.3, can't do math apparently. But yeah, you get two 1,000 pound bombs. But honestly, this thing, it's got a little bit of charm to it. Really, really fun. I am kind of curious of taking out the B-26 Marauder, though. Yes, this is definitely going to be a plane that I'm looking forward to sometime in the future. But with that being said, I hope you guys enjoy. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time. Goodbye.